Welcome, everyone, to our 2018 CEPR Economic Summit. I'm Mark Duggan, the Wayne and Jody Cooperman Professor of Economics here at Stanford, and I'm also the Trione Director of the Stanford Institute for Economic Policy Research, CEPR. We have, as many of you know, we have a jam-packed day that is about to begin, and I would say that the topics that we are exploring today could it'd be hard to imagine how they could be more timely. For the 15th year in a row, we're bringing in some of the most interesting names from the world of academia, business, government, and the media. And we have the added benefit that our sessions are pegged to some of the very biggest headlines of just the past few days and weeks. And we did plan this agenda months and months ago, but it's nice that it seems like many of our issues are really coming up, as we'll see as the day goes on. For example, just recently, North Korea said that it was willing to talk about an end to its nuclear weapons program. And just yesterday, President Trump reportedly accepted an invitation to meet for negotiations with Kim Jong-un. And today, we have a real treat with the very first session, Condoleezza Rice with us for a session that I'll be moderating titled The Changing World Order. And it's hard to imagine better timing for a conversation like this with a former Secretary of State and someone who's been such a wonderful friend to CEPR over the years. And there's been quite a lot happening on the economic policy front in Washington, D.C. as well this past week and in recent months. And my colleague and friend John Taylor will surely get a chance to delve into this with our evening session with Kevin Hassett, the chairman of the White House Council of Economic Advisors, who is an expert in tax policy and much more. And I just was very happy to see, I checked my phone right before coming in here, and it was an incredibly strong jobs report, another more than 300,000 jobs created last month, so things look really, really strong. So excited, though, to hear from the CEA chairman. A week after Time Magazine devoted an entire issue to the country's opioid crisis, we'll be covering that topic today with Ann Case and Anna Lemke, two of the leading scholars on the epidemic. And we're also going to apply an economic perspective to one of the most exciting and talked about areas of modern technology, robotics and artificial intelligence. And later, we have with us one of the country's most innovative governors, Gina Raimondo from Rhode Island, who will be talking about the challenges and opportunities playing out in state houses across America. I hope the Winter Olympics are still fresh in everyone's memory, because we'll be diving into the economics of the Olympic and Paralympic Games this afternoon. And I believe the Paralympic Games are actually starting today after the Olympics just wrapped up about a week ago. And for that, we're going to welcome Gene Sykes, who is the CEO of the LA 2028 Games, and Greg Meehan, who is Stanford's Director of Women's Swimming, for that panel. And I have to say, I'm just incredibly honored and delighted that we have so many high achievers and leaders in our midst today, including LinkedIn co-founder Reid Hoffman, Richard Waters from the Financial Times, James Manyika from McKinsey, and many others. But you know, I have to confess, at one level, I think the thing I'm most excited about today is for the first time getting to shake hands with an Olympic gold medalist, and not one, but two. Janet Evans and Maya Dorado will be here for our Olympic session. So very excited, both with nice Stanford connections. I also want to give a very big thanks to all of my Stanford colleagues who will be participating in today's panels: Susan Athey, David Crane, Mark Cullen, Nick Bloom, and Dan Bonet. They'll be leading and participating in some of the discussions in this room, as well as during our critical issue sessions that will begin at 4 o'clock. Before I go any further, I also want to give a huge thank you to our sponsors this year, Dodge & Cox, Heidrick & Struggles, and Dash. Their support has really been instrumental in making this year's summit possible. And we're also incredibly grateful to our supporters. Many of you have been our friends for years, and others who are relatively new to our orbit, and we thank you so much for making all that we do at CEPR possible. Your support is helpful not only for today's summit and for other events that we host throughout the year, but the research that our faculty and students are doing and creating opportunities for our students. Simply said, our success wouldn't be possible without your support, and so we are very grateful for that. CEPR has been a hub for economic policy research here at Stanford for more than three decades, and we've been helpful in attracting some of the brightest and most promising economists to the university. We analyze and we look for deeper understanding of economic trends and policies, and our scholars and faculty want to zero in on their impact and create knowledge that will better inform policymakers and the people who have influence so that policies are better around both in the US and around the world. And so again, thank you so much for your support. Now, I just want to cover a few logistics before we delve into the substance of the day. We're covering a lot of ground today, and you can be helpful to us by making sure that each session starts on time. So just paying attention to your program and trying to be back in time so that we stay on time throughout the day. And there are also information in your packets about the critical issues sessions today. They all start at 4 o'clock, so please start thinking now about which one you will be attending. I think it'll be difficult to choose one on China's new normal under President Xi, another one focusing on the impact of Brexit and what lies ahead, and a third that looks at crypto assets. Restrooms, if you need them, are right outside this door to the right, and there's another set further down, about 50 yards down. And we're recording most of the sessions from today's events and those videos from today's sessions, and those videos and summaries of each panel will be available through the CEPR website in about a week. We'll also be live tweeting from today's summit, and so feel free to join in on that conversation using the hashtag CEPR2018. Thank you so much to our speakers and panelists for spending so much time with us today. And I also want to give a very big thank you to our staff who have worked incredibly hard in making this happen. So please join me in thanking them.